raindrops. Drop top.
Drop top.
Smoking, no cooking the hot pot.
Cooking.
Fucking on your bitch, yeah, that, that, that.
Cooking up dope in the crock pot.
Pot. We came from nothing to something, nigga.
Hey.
I don't trust nobody, grip the trigger.
Nobody.
Call up the gang and they come and get gang.
Hey, what is up, guys? It's your boy, Eli, the great one, 17. I am back with another video. I know I've been gone for a while. To be honest, I haven't been feeling like posting lately. I don't know why, I just don't feel like posting. I don't play 2K a lot, really. I just play Fortnite. I started to play Fortnite. That game is really fun. So, yeah, I'm playing a lot of that. I barely play 2K18. I'm not saying the game's trash, because in my opinion, people might hate me for this, but in my opinion, I really like the game. Like, I don't know, I like it. I don't know if it's because I'm a big man or something. Like, I just like it. Like, big man in 2K18, you just think every, like, guards, it might be an issue, but, like, if you're having problems, and I guess you have a lot of money, you want to buy VC, I don't suggest you buy VC, because it's going to be a waste regardless, so don't do it. And talking about buying VC, you know, you want to test out your character. Obviously, we all know that in 2K18, you cannot test different characters, or you can test them, but we know to, like, try a new character, you have to go through long as hell cutscenes for no reason. All those prelude cutscenes for no reason. So I found a way to skip through all of that and just straight get into your player. But if you make this player like without cutscenes, I am not sure if you could play with him online. I haven't seen yet. If I hear anything about it, or if I try doing it and it works, I will inform you guys. But if not, it probably doesn't work. So yeah, this is pretty easy. All you have to do, really, it's easy on PS4. All you have to do, I don't have a thing, so I can't really show you. But what you have to do on PS4, I don't know about Xbox, but on PS4, all you want to do is just just disconnect your internet. So to do that on PS4, you just press the PlayStation button, go up, and then go to your settings, go to network, and then this says connect to internet, and it has a box. Press X on the box, and it will take you out. And then once you press X on the box, a menu like this, pretty much saying that certain features require connection to your PlayStation network. So you want to just press that. After you press that, it's going to keep on loading, and then when you go into it, it's just going to show you connect. It's not going to show you my team. It's just going to show you my career, my DM, my league. So what you want to do, hit my career and press triangle. Go to new my career. It will say access to online features is not available in this limited offline experience. It doesn't matter, just press X, because you're really not doing anything to your other player. So what you want to do is press X, right? And watch this, it'll take you right to the screen where you make your play and everything. Oh yeah, you select your team, let me pick the Cavs. I'm not a hype piece, guys, just, I like the Cavs. As you can see, you can make your players straight like that. You make him anything. If you wanna see my build, to be honest, it's just the center, post scoring rebounder is my opinion, like best thing in the game. Actually, no, it's not a post scoring rebounder. My bad, it's rebounding post score. I forgot. My dudes are. Oh yeah, sometimes this can happen. It'll just pop up again. But if it does, then don't worry about it. Just restart it again. Not restart it, but like, just press X, and it'll take you to your main menu. You just want to do the same thing you just did. Go into your micro thing, create a new one, press X, yada yada yada. Just skip through that thing. It'll take you to your player creation. And as I was saying before, the player that I made was a rebounding post scorer. In my opinion, it is hands down. Okay, not hands down. In my opinion, is top three center positions. My top three center position, I don't know why I'm saying this, but I'm just hoping you guys. My top three right now, post scoring giant finishing, that's like number one. The second one, post scoring defending. That two-way post score is like insane. And the last one is either a post scoring rebounder or a rebounding post scorer, which is pretty disgusting. But the reason I chose a post scoring rebounder is because I like rebounding, bro. Ask any, like, if you see how I play, I snag, and for a rebounding post score, what's it called? I don't know. I just like the stats better, to be honest. Like, I just like the rebounding post score stats better than a post score rebounder. I just like them better, to be honest. I think you have a higher mid range. Yeah, you have a higher mid range. I mean, no, you don't. My bad. You don't have a higher mid range. But, like, you have higher, like, higher stats, like, higher layups and stuff. And I just like that. I like having higher layups. Like, just, I like it. Like, you know, I just dunk on everybody. It's easy. Even though, yeah, post scoring. And the thing, good thing is, you still get your post scoring, some of your post scoring badges at gold. As you can see, three Hall of Fame badges. That is good for a post scoring, but you're going to get two. And that is Brick Wall and Bruiser, which are very essential. But for rewinding post score, you get Putback King. Also very essential if you play Pro-Am and My Park 2s. 2s, Putback King for center is essential. So, yeah, guys, that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. It's just a quick video, you know. Had to give you guys something. Haven't been here in a while, so yeah, it's just a quick video. Showing you guys, to be honest, my player and how to get this guy. So yeah, thank you for watching the video. I will see you guys later. Peace.